Hello students, how are you all? Enjoying? Yeah. I'm back, your physics teacher.
So what we were discussing? We were discussing the chapter Magnetic Effect of Electric Current. Okay, in this chapter we have completed the concept of electromagnetic induction in last lecture. So before starting the today's lecture, I want to show you something to develop your interest in today's lecture. All right, so let's go. So this you can see that what it is. Can you tell me? No, it is not a electric motor. It seems to be a electric motor, but it's not, because it has two split rings. In motor we had one split ring, and here it is two split rings, right? And in motor we have a battery connected with the brushes, but here we have galvanometer, not battery. So can you tell me what it is now? Yes, it is electric generator. Okay, hope you all understood what I am going to explain you today. I am going to explain you about electric generator. Okay, so electric generator was first invented by the Hungarian inventor and engineer Ennio Zedlik, right? They invented electric generator between 1827 and 1830. Between the years 1827 and 1830, Zedlik invented the generator. Okay, so who invented generator? Zedlik. And between the years 1827 to 1830, all right? So next, what is electric generator? Electric generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. One more difference in electric motor and electric generator, that electric motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy, but generator converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. They both are opposite. Generator use mechanical energy and converts electrical energy. Then what are the mechanical energies? It can use our energy, human power, or it can use wind with the help of windmills, or it can use turbines. These are the mechanical energy. With the help of these, a generator can get mechanical energy, and then it converts that mechanical energy into electrical energy. So generator is also known as dynamo. Okay. Now the principle of electric generator. As I explained, that electric generator works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. Now what was electromagnetic induction? When we move the coil between the magnetic field, then magnetic field varies near the coil. जब हम coil को move करते हैं तो magnetic field vary करती है coil के आसपास, around the coil. And because of the varying magnetic field vary करती है, उसकी वजह से एक induced EMF generate होता है. Okay, induced current generate होता है, and that is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic field. जितनी ज़्यादा magnetic field change होगी, उतना ज़्यादा electric current produce होगा, induced electric current produce होगा. All right, so it works on the principle of electromagnetic induction that we have discussed in the last lecture. Now what is the construction part? In construction we need two magnets for electric generator and a coil ABCD, as we have taken in the electric motor. But you can see here that in electric generator there are two split rings R1 and R2. You can see here are two split rings R1 and R2. But in motor we were having only one split ring, right? And the brushes are connected to the rings B1, B2. And then this B1 is connected to the galvanometer and B2 is also connected to the galvanometer. But in electric motor, these brushes were connected with the battery to supply an electric current. But here, we don't need electric current. We need mechanical energy. Okay? Construction you can understand in a better way with the help of animation. Let's see now. So here you can see that there are two split rings and split rings are connected with the brushes which are made up of carbon. Okay? And then that these brushes are connected with a galvanometer. Okay? And this coil is moving with the help of this split rings. What is the work of split rings? Split rings is used to move the coil. Okay? Split rings is used to move the coil, for the movement of coil. Okay? And this is coil we can move with the help of our hand or with the help of many things that I will tell you later on in this video. Okay? So, till this, your construction part is complete. Now let's come to the working part. How it works. So here you can see two split rings are connected with a load. This load will provide energy to the split rings and then split ring moves. And when split ring moves, then this coil will also move. How? Because this coil is connected with the split rings. As you can see, one end of coil is connected with one split ring and the another end of coil is connected with other split ring, right? So with the help of this load, these split rings will move, and with the help of these split rings this coil will move. Okay? And how the coil will move? Coil will move in upward direction. Okay? As you can see here that this part is moving upwards and this part is moving downwards. Okay? As you can see here that after applying load this split rings move and this part is moving upwards and this part is moving downwards. Okay? Coil is rotating. All right? So when coil rotate, जब coil rotate करेगी तो उसके आसपास magnetic field क्या होगी? Change होगी. When magnetic field gets change, तो उस time पर क्या होगा? Current produce होगा. At that time current will produce. And how we will know the direction of current? With the help of Fleming's right hand rule. Okay? That if we know the direction of force and we know the direction of magnetic field, then we will come to the direction of current. Then we will find the direction of current with the help of Fleming's right hand rule. Okay? So this we can understand from here that these two brushes are connected with the load and the load is transferring some energy to this brushes and from brushes the energy is transferred to the rings. Okay? And because of this energy, this coil will move, and when coil will move, magnetic field changes and current induces. Okay? So initially what we will see, jab coil move kar raha hai aur magnetic field change ho rahi hai, so with the help of Fleming's right hand rule what we found out that AB mein jo current ka direction hai that is upward aur CD mein jo current ka direction hai that is downward. Okay? This we have found in first case. But when we move it half, when we rotate this coil half, that means ए बी की जगह सी डी आ गया और सी डी की जगह ए बी आ गया, राइट। कंप्लीट रोटेशन कब होगा? जब ए बी वापस अपनी जगह पर आ जाएगा। बट हेयर व्हाट कैन वी सी कि ए बी की जगह सी डी आ गया एंड सी डी की जगह ए बी आ गया, राइट। दैट मीन्स इट इज़ हाफ रोटेशन, और हाफ रोटेशन होगा तो डिरेक्शन ऑफ करेंट विल गेट चेंज। बिकॉज क्या होगा, देखो जब हमने एनर्जी प्रोवाइड कराई थी तो एनर्जी तो इसी डायरेक्शन में जाएगी, राइट, क्योंकि एनर्जी को तो नहीं पता कि हमने कॉइल को रोटेट कर दिया है, कॉइल रोटेट हो चुका है, ए बी की जगह सी डी आ गया है, सी डी की जगह ए बी आ गया है, एनर्जी डजेंट नो अबाउट दिस। सो क्या हुआ यहाँ पर कि फर्स्ट केस यू कैन सी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज़ डाउनवर्ड एंड इन सेकेंड केस द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज़ अपवर्ड, ओके। एंड इन फर्स्ट केस द डायरेक्शन इन ए बी इज़ अपवर्ड एंड इन सेकेंड केस द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इन ए बी इज़ डाउनवर्ड, राइट, डाउनवर्ड हो गया। सो क्या हुआ कि डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट चेंज हो गया दोनों एंड्स पर। अगर मैं ए बी की बात करूँ तो अपवर्ड से डाउनवर्ड हो गया, सी डी की बात करूँ तो डाउनवर्ड से अपवर्ड हो गया, डायरेक्शन चेंज्ड, राइट। सो व्हेन डायरेक्शन इज चेंजिंग दैट मींस पोलैरिटी इज चेंजिंग, राइट। हमने इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चैप्टर में पढ़ा था दैट व्हेन करंट फ्लोज, तो करंट फ्लोज फ्रॉम नेगेटिव टू पॉजिटिव, राइट, इट फ्लोज फ्रॉम नेगेटिव टू पॉजिटिव। तो दैट मीन्स व्हेन द करंट इज फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम हेयर, दैट मीन्स नेगेटिव हेयर पॉजिटिव हेयर, एंड हेयर नेगेटिव इज हेयर एंड पॉजिटिव इज हेयर, एट दिस एंड नेगेटिव विल बिकम हेयर, पॉजिटिव इज हेयर एंड नेगेटिव इज हेयर पॉजिटिव इज हेयर, ठीक है। तो पोलैरिटी चेंज हो गई, बी पे पॉजिटिव पोलैरिटी थी, यहाँ पे बी पे नेगेटिव आ गई, यहाँ ए पे पोलैरिटी नेगेटिव थी, यहाँ ए पर पॉजिटिव आ गई, यहाँ सी पर पोलैरिटी नेगेटिव थी, यहाँ सी पर पॉजिटिव आ गई। तो पोलैरिटी सबकी चेंज होगी, तो व्हेन पोलैरिटी चेंजेस, ठीक है, अभी तो हाफ रोटेशन था तो पोलैरिटी चेंज हो गई, फिर से मैं अदर हाफ में ले आऊँगी तो पोलैरिटी सेम हो जाएगी। दैट मीन्स एट एवरी इन एवरी हाफ रोटेशन, इन एवरी हाफ रोटेशन पोलैरिटी इज चेंजिंग, क्या हो रहा है, पोलैरिटी चेंज हो रही है, राइट। इफ़ पोलैरिटी इज चेंजिंग That means this current is alternating current, ठीक है। Alternating current में polarity change होती है। Alternating current का अगर मैं graph की बात करूँ तो वो graph इस तरीके का होता है, ऑल राइट। हाफ इज़ पॉजिटिव, हाफ इज़ नेगेटिव, तो पॉजिटिव फिर नेगेटिव हो गया, फिर पॉजिटिव हो गया, फिर नेगेटिव हो गया, फिर पॉजिटिव हो गया, फिर नेगेटिव हो गया, राइट। तो इसी तरीके से यहाँ पर भी चेंज हो रही है पोलैरिटी। So that means generator gives us alternating current. What generator gives us? Alternating current. Now what if we want DC current, direct current? Now what if I want direct current? So for direct current what I do, कि मैं दो split rings की जगह सिर्फ एक split ring लगाऊंगी. At the place of these two split rings, I will keep only one split ring. Okay, that you can see here. That in this, here it is two split rings and here it is one split ring. Okay, this is AC generator and this is DC generator. Okay, on the basis of this, on the basis of output, okay, what this generator giving us? This generator is giving us output as current. Okay, तो output के basis पर, current के basis पर मैंने इस generators को दो parts में divide, दो टाइप्स में डिवाइड किया। आई डिवाइडेड इन टू टाइप्स, वन इज एसी एंड वन इज डीसी, ऑलराइट। बट व्हाट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ इनपुट, इनपुट में हम क्या दे रहे हैं, वी आर गिविंग मैकेनिकल एनर्जी। व्हाट वी आर गिविंग मैकेनिकल एनर्जी। तो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मैकेनिकल एनर्जी वी कैन डिवाइड इट इन नंबर ऑफ टाइप्स। दैट व्हाट आर द टाइप्स, फर्स्ट इज इंजन जनरेटर्स, we can give them mechanical energy with the help of engine, we can give them mechanical energy with human power, all right, we can give them mechanical energy as turbine, we can give them mechanical energy as windmill, right. So on the basis of output, there are two generators, and on the basis of input there are engine generator, human power generators, turbine and windmill generators. Okay, so now what is the difference between electric motor and electric generator? As you can see that here it is AC and DC, but when I replace these two rings with one ring, it becomes DC electric generator. And in motor also we were taking only one split ring, so this will work like a motor only. All right, so now let's see the difference between electric motor and generator. Electric motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy, and in electric generator converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. So we can understand this point with the help of, you have electric motor in your houses, right, to pump up the water into your tanks. Okay, we use electric motor to pump up the water into the tanks, right? इसीलिए हम मोटर को यूज़ करते हैं पानी ऊपर भेजने के लिए टैंक्स में. सो मोटर यूजेस इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी, आप उसमें स्विच होता है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोवाइड कराते हो, देन ओनली मोटर वर्क्स. ओके, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड लाइक दिस. एंड इन इलेक्ट्रिक जनरेटर, इन प्रीवियस डेज इफ यू टॉक अबाउट, आजकल तो सबके घर में इन्वर्टर्स होते हैं, बट इन प्रीवियसली वी हैड जनरेटर्स इन अवर हाउसेस. तो जब आपके घर में लाइट चली जाती थी तो वी यूज़ टू ऑन जनरेटर्स, एंड जनरेटर गिव्स अस द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी व्हेन देयर इज़ नो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन अवर हाउसेस. हमारे घर में इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चली जाती थी तो जनरेटर ऑन करके उस टाइम पे हम इलेक्ट्रिसिटी को यूज़ करते थे. तो जनरेटर क्या करता था, मैकेनिकल एनर्जी लेता था और हमें इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी देता था, राइट? सो इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर यूजेज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. Just I explained the example of that motor, you have to pump up the water, वो electricity use करता है, then ही वो water ऊपर चढ़ाता है, and it generates electricity. As I just explained कि हमारे घर में light चली जाती थी तो हम generator को use करते थे, and generator gives us the electricity. Okay, now what is the main difference, that it uses the principle of current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. When we place current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, it experiences a force, that we find the direction of force with the help of Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, and electric generator based on the principle of electromagnetic induction, and here we will find the direction of current with the help of Fleming's right hand rule. Okay, so these were the differences between electric motor and electric generator. This is very important part. You should know the difference between electric motor and electric generator. Hope you all have understood it very well. So now I would like to show you the working of electric generator in an animation part. Okay, so let's see. So here you can see this ABCD coil is moving with the help of one handle, right? That handle we are moving with our hand. Okay, now we will know the direction of current in both the sides, AB and CD, with the help of Fleming's right hand rule. Okay, and electricity is generating, that we will come to know with the help of galvanometer. That direction of current is from B1 to B2, right? You can see here this ABCD is coil moving with a handle, that we are moving with our hand, and the direction of current we will know with the help of Fleming's right hand rule on the both ends, right? And this current we can measure, that current is present inducing or not, with the help of galvanometer. Okay, hope you all have understood the concept of electric generator very well. If you have any doubt, you can ask anytime. Okay, so till my next video, bye bye, take care everyone.